The Bella twins left the ring in favor of focusing on other interests. Their families have also grown considerably since retiring from in-ring competition, but they say there's one more run left in them. WWE proposed a feud with the Iconic vs Bella twins while Peyton Rhodes and Billy Kay were champions. Obviously, that didn't pan out for several reasons. The Iconic were split up, much to the disdain of Peyton Rhodes, but Nikki and Brie Bella might have a comeback in store. While speaking to Access, Brie Bella addressed the possibility of making an in-ring return. She did not write off the idea as they had in the past. "See, this is what's hard for Nikki and me, because when we left, all of the sudden the WWE Women's Tag Titles came, and we are like, wait a sec, that's for the Bella twins. Like, we have been dying to have a tag titles. And Soha and I feel like we have one more run in us. We really want those tag titles. We will have to see what's next for the Bella twins. Total Bellas is still shooting and there are not any sign of that show stopping. A return to the ring could make a fascinating story for an upcoming season of their reality show."WWE brought Braun Strowman over to the Red Brand as part of the 2020 WWE draft. He was already appearing on Raw Underground before that weekly segment was dropped. The company also made a change to the Monster Among Men's character while they were at it. According to PW Insider, WWE has quietly moved Braun Strowman over into the babyface column. He was flipped from being a heel on SmackDown to a babyface on Raw. This happened without any real storyline reason. Although Strowman was flipped to the heel side on SmackDown after being pulled into a swamp by Bray Wyatt and just a few weeks ago purposely low-blowed Keith Lee, Strowman is internally considered a babyface for the Raw brand. We will have to see how this turns out for Braun Strowman. WWE did not air a tribute to the troops special last year, but they did hold an event. The 18th annual event will air on Fox on December 6th, but it will not air at the same time for everyone. In WWE's press release about the upcoming special, it is stated that fans with a Fox affiliate airing an NFL game on December 6th will view tribute to the troops at an alternate time. Viewers with an NFL matchup airing at 1 PM Eastern can watch WWE tribute to the troops at 4:30 PM Eastern. Viewers with an NFL matchup airing at 4:05 PM Eastern can watch the special at 3 PM Eastern. Tribute to the troops will take place inside the award-winning Thunderdome inside the Amway Center. This event will be pre-recorded, but it's unknown when WWE will tape the upcoming military theme event. Karrion Kross won the NXT title, but he didn't hold it for very long at all. Kross was forced to relinquish his title when he suffered a separated shoulder in that match against Keith Lee. The former Killer Kross got right back in the gym as soon as he could, and he's feeling great. Kross updated fans via an Instagram video of him working out in the gym. "He feels absurdly stronger than he ever has before. He isn't clear to return just yet, but this kind of update is certainly a great sign." Finn Balor was injured with a broken jaw and he hasn't returned either. Rey Mysterio's return to WWE was eventually followed by his son Dominik and daughter Aliyah finding a spotlight. Dominik is a WWE superstar and competing in matches. Aliyah's situation with WWE is a bit different as she has not signed an actual contract. Mysterio is having a great time in this run, but it can't last forever. While speaking to Chasing Glory recently, Rey Mysterio said that he doesn't see himself wrestling past his 50th birthday. He's 45 years old now, but he feels great. Mr. 619 also discussed something he's doing along the way to improve his performance, like stem cells and CBD. "I'll be 45 in December and I don't see myself going past 50, that's for sure. My body feels great right now. I have been doing new methods of therapy. Stem cells, hyperbaric chambers, cryo chambers, CBDs, you know, a lot of things that benefit me. I think that has given me more longevity." He doesn't see himself leaving WWE. Mysterio planned to retire under the company's umbrella. As he said, "You can't go any higher than this." He always envisions himself concluding his career with WWE. This also seemed to erase hope that he might eventually land in AEW. Marie is written off WWE television when the It couple announced that she was pregnant with their second child. She hasn't been hard to find as Miss and Mrs. Carrie Don. While speaking to the Sam Robert podcast, Marie discussed the chances that she will return to the ring. "You can never say never, but she's a mother of two and very busy. In the end, Marie is confident that she will return in some capacity. It is just about waiting for the right opportunity. Always the thing about me is I will think. I have kids, I have a family, but also when I start getting excited about something, that is something that my brain gets busy with. And my husband is money in the bank. WrestleMania might be in Los Angeles. You start adding all these elements. Also the fact that I love WWE, I love everything about it. It's been my family for so long." Maurice is clearly interested in returning to the WWE. It would be nice to see how WWE creative would try and tie her into a storyline with the Miz and John Morrison. WWE made a lot of cuts in 2020, and now another famous name in the company is gone. Tony Kimmel has been let go by WWE, but he wasn't alone. According to PW Insider, WWE let even more staff go on Friday. It was confirmed that the number is around 10 to 15 in total. Mostly logistical and behind-the-scenes staffers were cut. Tony Kimmel was among those who was released by the company. He has been with WWE since 1991, and he was well known as an announcer on the SmackDown brand. In recent years, he worked mostly behind the scenes.